Right now, I'm going to show you the easiest way to grab a photo that has black or white and convert it into any color you want inside of Photoshop. We'll colorize this photo in a minute, but why don't I start by just showing you black and white so I can explain exactly what's going on. With this layer selected, we're going to grab the adjustment layer, and the adjustment layer that we're going to use is hue saturation. So we're going to pop it open, and you can see there's the settings. Now we're going to choose the colorize. Now notice as we look at this, no color is changing, and maybe this is something you've run into. Even if we turn the saturation all the way up, or we adjust the hue, there's no color showing through. And that's because there's no color present in black or white to shift. So the secret to all of this is lightness. I've seen some people use this to lighten and darken images. Please don't do that. Use levels or curves for that. This is what lightness does. Look at the black, for example. We can't add color to black because it's already 100% black. So if we lighten it up a little bit. Now, as we lighten it, look at this. It's no longer black. And that means that we can change the color with the hue. We can change the amount of color with the saturation. If we lighten it more, we get more shades of color. Same thing with white. You can't colorize white because there's no color in it. Black would be 0 out of the 256 levels. White would be 255 out of the 256 levels. The reason it's 255 is it starts counting at 0. Let's hit colorize. So let's darken the white so it's no longer pure white. Notice now we can apply color in here. We can change what color we want. We can change the saturation or the amount of that color. Okay, so it's all good and proper to do that on an example. Let's apply it in the real world. Right now we have this picture of a woman and she has a white t-shirt and we want to apply a little bit of color. So let's select the layer. And then we're going to choose our hue saturation adjustment layer, just like we did before. Now, I want to make sure it only affects the layer directly underneath and not the whole stack. And you can do that by hitting that little icon there. See that arrow appears? That means now it's just affecting the layer underneath. And of course, in this layer underneath, I've actually cut out the shirt. I'll hang around to the end and I'll show you how I did that. All right, so we hit our hue. Notice we can change a little bit of the color in this shirt. See how it's changing? And the reason for that is not much in the real world is actually going to be pure black or pure white. It's going to be influenced by the color of the light, the ambient light. So we can turn up the saturation if we want, but notice it gets really noisy and grainy and not good looking. So we're going to hit colorize. First thing that's going to do is it's going to get rid of all that weird color. Now we can hit the saturation a little bit more. Now maybe you've done this before, you change the hue and you can adjust the colors, right? Pretty good. But you're super limited. All you're getting is these pastel colors. You want good, strong, deep color. Remember what I showed you before? Take this lightness, bring it down, and look at this. Now we can find decent color, strong color. Maybe we'll go to something like a red, or look at this, nice orange, a nice red. Maybe it's a little too saturated. Pull back the saturation, just kind of keep things real. By the way, if you take the lightness back, you can get deeper tones. Look at this. Just be wary with the saturation when you do that. So look at that, we can dial in a very beautiful red. And of course, you know, if it's not perfect like it isn't here, this isn't a session on masking. All you do is just select the mask and grab a brush. You know, and we can just paint that in. What am I doing here? I'm just using a white brush. But once again, you know, this isn't a session on selections and masking. I'm just trying to show you how to do the color. All right. So as you can see, we can really go in and we can punch those colors. Same thing with the skirt. If we wanted to do the blacks, we could go in, grab our hue saturation, clip it. And by the way, the another way to do that quicker is hold down the Alt or Option key and just click in between the adjustment layer and the layer. It does the same thing. It turns on that little option. And then we hit colorize. Now you want to lighten it a little bit. And you know, and if you want it, yeah, you could put some different color in there. I don't necessarily think it's going to look good for the skirt to do that. But I'm just saying, you know, if you wanted to do that, you know, you can get all these colors. They're all there. Okay, I told you I was going to show you how easy it is to select things like white and black. Let me do that right now. To select the white, it's as simple as just going under Select and using Color Range. I have other tutorials on this, so I'm not going to go in depth, but I'll just show you what I did. And you can just choose Highlights. Take the fuzziness down. The range, as you increase the range, it gets more. As you decrease it, it gets less. So essentially, this is what we do. We just dial in the white area. Use the fuzziness to clean up that selection. Essentially, we've got our selection there. Click OK. And then you're just going to create a mask. And then what I did is I just grabbed the lasso tool here around that area. Select inverse. Fill that with black. And there we go. We've cut out the shirt. It's as simple as that. And to select the black, select color range. Instead of highlights, just use shadows. And do the same thing, and it'll select the dark parts of the image. So I hope you found this useful. Let me know in the comments if you learned anything new here, and if this helped you dial in those colors you've been trying to get in Photoshop that have been difficult. As you can see now, it's really not difficult at all. So anyway, guys, if you're new, welcome to the cafe. Great to have you here. Do me a favor, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any tutorials from me. And by the way, guys, if you like this, do me a favor and hit that like button. It helps us with the YouTube algorithm. All right, until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.